Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video. So I'm actually going to be doing some of my Marvel Legends unboxings. We're going to get into those. These are going to be the Marvel Comics series of Spider-Man. Really, really cool. So anyway, I'm going to show you the back of one of the boxes. You can see on the back here. Now, the character that's featured up top is not going to be featured down here. So this one, for example, this box is going to be Electro's box. So down here, you're going to be able to get Spider-Man, Peter Parker, who has another changeable head, Green Goblin, Gwen Stacy, who has a Mary Jane head with her, and Daredevil, who also has a second head as well. So this is what the boxes are going to look like. There's also a Kingpin that I did pre-order as well. In this video, we are going to be unboxing Gwen Stacy. Let's get into it. Okay, so here we have Mary Jane. Very, very cool. Now, she came with... Actually, it was Gwen Stacy who came with a Mary Jane head, head swap. Now, I'm glad that I have both characters, I'll say that. I'm really glad that I do have both, but I think it was kind of lazy to do a head swap of, you know, two different characters in the same head. You get the same thing with the Danny Moonstar. You get her, Wolfsbane, and I can't remember the other girl's name, but you get all three of them together in one collection. And I thought that was kind of a little bit lazy. I guess, you know, it's motivating you to go and get more. Now, with the X-Men girls, it's not such a bad thing because of the fact that they all wear, like, the same sort of outfit. So that's not really terrible. But you really don't want a Mary Jane and a Gwen Stacy wearing the exact same thing. That's kind of weird. So I thought, like, they should have just done two different girls. Or maybe have done, like, a two-pack. That might have been exclusive to somewhere of, like, Mary Jane and maybe Peter with, you know, no mask on or anything like that. Something, just something like that to that effect. It's not a terrible head swap. In fact, I did find another body that I'm going to put Mary Jane on. The only problem with that, because I do like the way Mary Jane looks actually better than Gwen in this. But the other body that I'm going to use, I don't really think that Gwen would wear that, if that makes sense. So I'm going to just kind of put Mary Jane in that outfit. Or I could go buy a second one. But again, I don't really want to do that only because of the fact that they're wearing the same thing. I did try other bodies that I thought she could, one of the girls could wear, but they're all mostly superheroes. So they're all wearing, like, you know, superhero get-ups versus just like regular, normal, everyday clothes. Probably one of the most nostalgic things I think that I think of when I was a kid, two things actually. I had like a Mary Jane figure. I don't know if it was McDonald's or Burger King, but they had like a little Spider-Man collection. I had Spider-Man and then I had Mary Jane, and Mary Jane would come with like different dresses you could put on her. It was weird. It was a weird little like plastic tiny little figure, but I still have that figure somewhere. And I kept that one for the longest time. I think she's wearing like a pink jacket and has like a yellow shirt and some jeans on or something like that. And then you could like, you can flip like between three different dresses that she would have on. Like they were like little plastic pieces and you connect it to like the little hole that's on the side of her jacket. But yeah, it was just, I remember that toy. And then I remember another two pack, I think, that came out when I was really, really young, of Mary Jane and Spider-Man together. I think it was a Toys R Us. I don't remember if it was like an exclusive there or something like that, but that's one thing I remember about Mary Jane, was that like she had like really interesting toys. Yeah, growing up I had a few different Spider-Man toys. I had like, growing up I had like, I think only one Spider-Man toy. I had it for the longest time, and I used to have him like next to my Superman and my Batman. So that was a really cool figure. I only had, like I said, one Mary Jane figure. So it's cool now that like, now that I'm into Marvel, you know, Marvel Legends and stuff, and they're coming up with so many really cool characters and figures from shows I used to love. I'm really all into it. I kind of did want that Peter Parker, Mary Jane 2 set that I found on eBay, but I actually like this set more. I do think it's possible that I may end up getting that set though at some point, only because of the fact that, you know, I really like Mary Jane in this outfit, but again, I don't really see Gwen in the other outfit that I found, or the other, you know, body mold that I found that I think would go good. And I actually saw both of them in it. Mary Jane kind of looks a little bit better. She's something about the red hair, I think, matching the other outfit that I found, or the other, you know, body that I found. Their skin tone is a little bit different from the body, the skin tone of the body, but I think it still works. You'll have to see when it's all done. And then this is Mary Jane, once again, back to center. And now we're going to go ahead and get into Gwen Stacy. And then this is also something that Mary Jane and Gwen come with. Middletown High School sort of book that looks really, really cool. And then they have like a Daily Bugle, a kind of rolled up newspaper. But yeah, that's what they come with. All right, and then here we have Gwen Stacy. Once again, there was a head swap. So you get Gwen, and then you get a head swap of Mary Jane. I don't know if you guys have any other tips for, like, what I should do with the Mary Jane head as far as, you know, finding her another body replacement. Is there another character that would go really well with her? I'm not going to waste too much time on this one showing you too much of the body, obviously, because we've seen enough of that. I'll just kind of show you the head. I guess I could just kind of save the Gwen Stacy head for like a Spider Gwen or something like that. However, like I said, I do kind of like the idea of a casual Gwen Stacy as well, instead of just, you know, Spider Gwen. So I don't know, we'll see what happens. I think one thing I definitely really like about the heads, I have to say, is that they have their, you know, own unique individuality, which I think is really important. You know, the girls don't look exactly alike, even though their skin tone is the same. They don't look exactly alike. The hair flows differently. Obviously, the hair color is different. She's rocking a band. The back of her head, the hair, and it kind of flows out, you know, in a different way. I think her length is actually longer. So I like that they did different things with the girls, so that each head feels very different from the other. It doesn't feel like they like a sort of a copy and a paste, or sort of like a palette swap of the heads. That's really important too. Here she is to the back. Again, I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about with the hair, like how the hair flows differently. You know, this hair kind of curls a little bit to some degree. This one in the back really doesn't do too much of that. A little bit on this side, but not as dramatic as that one does. Like I said, I think Gwen's hair is a little bit longer as well. Also, Mary Jane's hair has like parts in the front where Gwen's is just completely to the back. So yeah, again, it really helps kind of separate them, kind of make them feel like two different people when their heads are connected to the body, and that's important. This is the other side of Gwen. I really like the way the Gwen Stacy head looks on this body, but I also like the way Mary Jane does too, and I hate that. I hate that they look, both of them look really, really good in this body. I do like Mary Jane a little bit more. However, I really do like this side profile of Gwen. I like this side better than the other side, and I do see a little bit of a paint issue right here. But it's not a big deal. Like, for me, the paint issues are not a huge deal. And that's such a small one that it doesn't really bother me at all. There's probably other ones you guys have pointed out or spotted out while I'm doing this. And I really don't look for those unless they're, like, blatantly obvious. So, all right, that is the end of this one. Again, this is going to be the Gwen Stacy with the Mary Jane head swap. Let me know which one you guys prefer in the comments. Do you guys like the Mary Jane head more or the Gwen Stacy head? I'd really love to know what you guys think. And like I said, if you guys have any ideas on who I should, what body I should use for my Mary Jane, let me know in the comments as well. All right, guys, this is the end of the video. As you can see, this next to Gwen Stacy is going to be Mary Jane in the Jean Grey Age of Apocalypse Sugar Man figure build set. I used that one. I just thought this looked good on her. Her and Jean don't look too different. And then also, she also kind of reminds me of Black Widow as well. So, I mean, I could use a Black Widow body as well, if I wanted to. But I think this one looks a little bit less superhero-y, just in my opinion, than the others. It's not like a full, complete bodysuit. I mean, it kind of is, but it also isn't. You know what I mean? Like, she's got, like, the jacket on. There's sort of, like, a little, kind of looks like a little scarf neck piece there. So it just looks a little bit more fashionable, I think, than just a straight up one piece like she's a superhero. I mean, it does have a superhero look to it as well, but this is kind of the closest thing that I could really find. And I think it actually complements her pretty well. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Again, if there's anything you guys would put her in, or another body, or just get, you know, if I should just get another figure, which I'm probably going to end up doing anyway. It's just, again, I don't want them wearing the same thing. I could change the colors up, though. Like, I'm pretty good at repainting things, so I could do that if I wanted to, but that just kind of feels like more work as well. So I don't know. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for all you guys do. Thank you for your likes, your follows, subscribes. Thank you so much for sharing. If you guys are not subscribed to the channel yet, you already know what to do. Make sure to hit the subscribe button, ring the bell for notifications, so anytime I have a brand new video, you guys are notified about it. And I will see you guys in the next one. Have a great day. Peace.